When you think of heart disease, you may think of friends or loved ones who have suffered from a heart attack before. Perhaps they had symptoms leading up to their heart attack, such as shortness of breath, pain in their chest, until finally this cruel condition got the better of them. But for the majority of people who die from a heart attack, their very first event is their only symptom. That's why, whether you have any symptoms or not, we want to arm you with knowledge. Knowledge of how to avoid heart disease, get energy back, and enjoy your golden years with your loved ones. So it's time for us to reveal the top 15 tips to beat heart disease. Let's begin. Number 15, put down the sweet stuff. When people consume high amounts of sugar, their risk for heart disease dramatically increases. This is especially true for a type of sugar called fructose. Fructose is found in many sweeteners, but in particular in high fructose corn syrup. This is the main sweetener in soft drinks. In 2014, a large trial published in JAMA, the Journal of American Medical Association, showed that sugar caused cardiovascular disease. People who ate the most sugar had an increased death rate of 250%. So put down the soft drink, get rid of the candy bars, cookies, and ice cream, and enjoy a healthier life. Number 14, cut the carbs. Next on our list for beating heart disease is cutting the carbs, and more precisely, the processed ones, such as breads, pasta, noodles, and cereals. And yes, that does include the ones with the heart healthy logos. What many people do not realize is that these foods dramatically increase blood sugar levels, which is exactly what you do not want to do. High blood sugar levels cause our cells to not work optimally. This can lead to inflammation, which can cause cardiovascular disease. Rather than eat processed carbohydrates, fill up on sweet potatoes, whole grains like quinoa. And if you're craving pasta, choose kelp noodles, or make your own noodles by spiralizing zucchinis. Number 13, ditch the rancid oils. Consuming the wrong types of fats can be catastrophic when it comes to heart disease. For example, trans fats have been found to double the risk of cardiovascular disease for each 2% increase in consumption. Similarly, vegetable oils such as corn, soy, and canola are associated with higher risk of heart disease. They are highly inflammatory, and as we've already mentioned, inflammation can lead to heart disease. Avoiding foods that cause an inflammatory response is crucial in keeping heart disease at bay. So ditch your vegetable oils and turn instead to extra virgin olive oil or coconut oil. These may be more expensive, but they're worth every penny if they help you prevent heart disease. Next, we come to foods that combine a deadly concoction of all the foods we've already mentioned, and that is fast food. So our number 12 tip is to forget fast food. Of course, fast food is made up of processed carbohydrates, sugars, and rancid oils. A 1997 study published in the American Journal of Cardiology found that a single fast food meal can stiffen your arteries within hours. Plus, the arteries' ability to relax naturally were cut in half. Therefore, avoiding fast food is crucial for your cardiovascular health. So far, we have looked at what we need to avoid to beat heart disease. So now let's look at what delicious foods we can add to our diets. Number 11, enjoy fresh fish. Having a diet rich in the essential fatty acid omega-3 found in oily fish is one of the best ways to get heart healthy. One 2006 study found that participants who ate fish one or two times a week had a 36% lower risk of coronary heart disease. This may be due to the anti-inflammatory nature of omega-3s that's found in the fish. Also, seafood is a great source of protein, and it won't send your blood sugar soaring. One of our favorite forms of fish is wild Alaskan salmon. Not only is it rich in healthy omegas, but it's also a wonderful source of potassium. This is an essential mineral when it comes to keeping blood pressure in a healthy range. When choosing fish, go for smaller ones, as larger fish can have high levels of toxin. and whenever possible, choose wild caught. Farmed fish can be very high in chemicals. This is especially true of farmed salmon. So treat yourself to a delicious meal of wild caught salmon. For bonus points, eat it with a fresh salad or steamed veggies a couple of times a week, and your heart will thank you for it. The countdown from number 1 to 10 is coming up, but don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Heart Disease Code. We've got amazing new content each week. Right now, we're giving away 2 free gifts. You can get both by clicking the link in the description below. More on that later. But now, back to the list. Number 10. Enjoy nature's candy. Berries, or nature's candy as we like to call them, are probably one of the best fruits to have in your diet. They're low in sugar, but loaded in nutrients and antioxidants. Antioxidants help prevent damage being done to cells by mopping up free radicals. Free radicals are waste products from foods we eat and toxins we're exposed to, so mopping these up and protecting our cells is crucial. Having our cells in good working order helps keep heart disease at bay. Berries also contain a special plant compound called anthocyanins, which helps lower cholesterol. A study done on 34,000 postmenopausal women found that participants who consumed anthocyanin-rich berries once per week or more experienced significant reductions in risk of death from coronary artery disease. Adding these to your diet is an easy and delicious way to protect your heart. Number 9. Eat the rainbow. Eating vegetables should be the cornerstone of any healthy eating plan. This is something almost all health and wellness experts agree on. The vegetable kingdom is loaded with plant compounds. These range from antioxidants to anti-inflammatories, polyphenols to flavonoids, and minerals to, of course, vitamins. All these play a crucial role in allowing your body to function optimally and especially your cardiovascular system. Eating plenty of vegetables ensures we have enough dietary fiber too. Fiber is important because it allows us to have regular bowel movements, but it's also associated with a lower risk of heart disease and healthier cholesterol levels. So get creative and enjoy at least 5 serves a day of vegetables. Next on our list, could this food be one of the secrets to avoid obesity as well as protecting your heart? Our number 8 tip is go nuts. If you don't eat nuts already, then I hope you will start. They have a wide array of benefits, being a great source of fiber, vitamin E, and a variety of minerals. But when it comes to heart health, there are certainly some interesting findings. One 2011 study found that despite the fact that nuts are high in calories, those who ate more had the lowest rates of obesity. Interesting, huh? As I'm sure you're aware, obesity is one of the major risk factors for heart disease, so avoiding this is crucial. But there's more that this study found. The participants with the highest nut intake also had decreased waist circumference, blood pressure, and blood sugar, as well as higher levels of HDL cholesterol, commonly known as the good cholesterol. So why not try adding nuts to your diet? There are many ways to enjoy them. They make a great snack on the go. They can be chopped and added to all sorts of meals, such as salad and stir fries. Or if you like to have a dessert in the evening, add chopped walnuts and cinnamon to Greek yogurt. Number 7. Spice up your life. Herbs and spices contain a tremendous amount of antioxidants and nutrients. Many of these have cardioprotective capabilities. One spice which is particularly potent when it comes to cardiovascular health is turmeric. It contains a special compound called curcumin, which can help reduce inflammation and oxidation of cells. As we've already discussed, protecting our cells from damage allows them to work well. This in turn can help in the fight against heart disease. Several studies suggest that intake of curcumin leads to improvement in endothelial function. In other words, your blood vessel lining can work more efficiently. All in all, this spice may be the number one spice in the fight against heart disease. So add it to curries, soups, scrambled eggs, or even use it to make a warming turmeric latte or tea. Now, if you enjoy your tea, you certainly won't want to miss our number 6 way to beat heart disease. Number 6, enjoy a cuppa. Sipping on a hot cuppa can certainly aid in the morning routine. And studies have shown that drinking green tea specifically can help in the fight against heart disease. Experts believe green tea is beneficial for our heart because of two main reasons. Firstly, it has copious amounts of antioxidants which protect your heart and blood vessels. Secondly, it can help lower triglycerides. High triglyceride levels being a huge risk factor for heart disease. A 2004 article by Japanese researchers from Chiba Hukuso Hospital exploring the effects of green tea on coronary artery disease concluded that the more green tea patients consume, the less likely they are to have coronary artery disease. The top five, counting down to number one on our list of the best tips to beat heart disease, is coming up, and we'll reveal why your smile is important when it comes to preventing heart disease. But it's time to let you in on a world of knowledge about heart disease and nutrition. If you ever wanted to know why heart disease rates all over the world are skyrocketing and what you can do to prevent it, then join our Heart Disease Code program today. Clicking the link in the description below will give you two free gifts from Heart Disease Code. Discover the truth about fat and cholesterol, plus watch the first episode of our comprehensive documentary series, The Untold Story of Heart Disease. Experience the most extensive collection of heart disease knowledge in this year's making of the documentary series. We spoke to some of the world's leading cardiologists and researchers on heart disease to uncover how you can fight and prevent heart disease with easy steps that allow you to transform your health and that of your loved ones. To get these two free gifts, all you need to do is click the link below. Number five, eat olive oil. The Mediterranean diet has long been associated with heart health, and olive oil may be the secret sauce to this diet. And many studies have proven its cardioprotective abilities due to the factors such as its ability to lower inflammation, improve the function of blood vessel lining, lower blood pressure, and even protect LDL cholesterol from becoming oxidized, a process which results in cholesterol causing damage to the cardiovascular system. Using this oil to cook could be one of the easiest switches to make for building a heart-healthy lifestyle. However, a word of caution, always use extra virgin olive oil. Extra virgin olive oil has been cold-pressed to keep it from going rancid. As we've already discussed, rancid oil can have a negative impact on heart health. Number four, breathe deeply. You may be wondering, what has breathing got to do with anything other than the basic function of keeping you alive? But did you know that getting into a deep state of rest can do wonders for your heart health? This was proven by cardiologist Herbert Benson, who coined the term the relaxation response. This is where he taught patients to alter their physical and emotional response to stress. But how did he do it? Through deep breathing and calming the mind. By teaching his patients, he saw a decrease in heart rate, lower blood pressure, slower rate of breathing, and more relaxed muscles. This state also increased a molecule called nitric oxide that's critical for blood flow and circulation. Now for number three, get off the couch and get your body moving. This is also crucial for blood flow and circulation, but there's also a plethora of studies proving that regular exercise prevents cardiac events. This is for both first-time and secondary events. One Harvard University study tracked male participants for 16 years. This study found that those who burned 2,000 calories or more exercising weekly saw significant benefits, a 39% reduction in developing heart disease and a 24% reduction in cardiovascular mortality. However, don't think you need to start training for a marathon. A 2014 study that to reduce your risk of dying from a heart attack by one-third, just 5 to 10 minutes of daily jogging is all you need. So without further ado, put on your running shoes, get your body moving and your heart pumping. Number two, have a beautiful smile. You might be wondering what your smile has to do with heart health, but numerous studies have now shown that poor oral health leads to a greater risk of heart disease. The reason for this is, if you have an infection or inflammation in your mouth, it can lead to systemic inflammation. This in turn can cause damage to the cardiovascular system. Therefore, getting rid of any infections or inflammation in the mouth is key. Some great steps to take are flossing daily and wherever possible brushing after every meal. If your gums bleed or you think you may have an infection, seek out advice from a biological dentist. We're about to unveil our number one best tip to beat heart disease. Just don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Heart Disease Code. And also be sure to grab both of your two free gifts, The Truth About Fat and Cholesterol, and episode one of The Untold Story of Heart Disease by clicking the link in the description below. Number one, get quality sleep. The quote, "Your future depends on your dreams, so go to sleep," couldn't ring truer when it comes to beating heart disease. When we sleep, our body repairs from the mental and physical stress of the day. Without quality sleep, our body cannot function optimally. Many studies have shown the connection between getting good quality sleep and heart health. A good example of this is a 2011 study that had over 20,000 participants. They found that those who had less than 6 hours of sleep had a 23% higher risk of heart disease than those who slept longer than 7 hours a night. And from those who slept less than 6 hours a night, those with poor quality sleep had a 79% increased risk of developing cardiovascular disease compared to normal sleepers. So not only is the amount of sleep that we get important, but also the quality of our sleep. Allowing yourself time in the evening to wind down can help you get a good night's sleep. This can be done by turning down lights and staying away from devices close to bedtime. Also, keeping the bedroom dark, quiet, and cool can help significantly to ensure good quality sleep. Well, that's our list. Did you find this video helpful? Let us know in the comments section below. And don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to keep updated on our latest videos. Also, click the magical link in the description below to claim your two free gifts, The Truth About Fat and Cholesterol ebook, and the premiere episode of The Untold Story of Heart Disease. Thanks for watching and have a heart healthy day.